Yeah, yeah. What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Raw Truth Show. We back for 2020 on Raw Truth Radio. You can go to rawtruthradio.com right now and listen to the radio show live. You know, you follow me on Instagram, Facebook, at Kubi TV. You know, so we're going to have a special guest a little later on. And, you know, I want to talk about some stuff. We're going to talk about, first of all, we got to talk about staying safe. Clean your hands, wash your face, wear gloves, put a mask on, like all the time, all day, every day. No hesitation, you know what I'm saying? We definitely got to talk about that. I want to also talk about, do you think there's going to be a summer league this year in all these big time tournaments, or what's going to happen? Another subject we want to talk about is, are the kids going to finish school? That's another big topic. You know, my son's right now, he home doing his work online. You know, teachers are online doing this teaching and stuff. So, you know, it's weird. This is really serious. It's not a game out there. You know, we don't want nobody getting sick and dying on us and all that good stuff. So, we need to know what to do and how to take care of yourself and all of that. There's special remedies people are saying and, you know, stuff like that. I tried that and I don't know. You know, I don't know if it works. You know, I'm just trying to stay safe. You know what I'm saying? If people have special remedies, text me, call in. You know, call in and see if you can help people out with different things and different remedies. You know what I'm saying? So, the NBA, what's going to happen with them? Basically, all professional sports. Football is later on, so are they going to have a season? Is the NBA going to finish their season? I was talking with a college coach the other day. We're going to talk about that too, about how they're deciding to, the NCAA is deciding to give the seniors a fifth year because of what went on and what's going on. Now, do they want to graduate and stay at the same school, or are they going to graduate and transfer for that fifth year to another program? You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know what's going on. Is that going to mess up the scholarship money for the school itself? You know? Also, we got the Corona Mix Volume 1 playing in the background. That's made by Kid Kubi, and it's kind of dope. I'm working on getting some more artists, some new artists to send in music. You can send music in to kickingitwithkubi.com. That's KickinitWithKubi.com. KickinitWithKubi43@gmail.com. What's going on, everybody, for tuning in? Thanks for tuning in and watching. You can also go to www.rawtruthradio.com and listen to it live on the radio. If you're in your car, you know what I'm saying, you can easily plug in and listen to it. So, you know, just check it out. So, let's start with the first topic. Let's start with high school. Let's start with schooling with the kids. What do you think is really going to happen? What is going to go on? What's happening with the schools? Right now, they're doing homeschooling on the computer. You know, and it's not bad. My son is, you know, he's getting up. He's going to get his computer. He's getting online. But the only problem I have a little bit is that he's he's like rushing through it, trying to get it done fast, you know. And so when we look back at it, then we got to go back over it again, and he has to do it again type thing, you know. Then we having him also So Facebook is not going to play, they're not going to stay live because I'm playing the music in the background, you know, even though my man Mike G is the owner of Raw Truth Radio, and we're underneath the Raw Truth Radio station. So, you know, that's what, you know, Facebook, Instagram, they always want to try to control something. And then, you know, when you have something good or something going on positive, they want to try to shut it down, you know. But it's all good. We're going to continue. So you can go to www.rawtruthradio.com and listen to it live. So we have the schooling. Kids are doing homeschooling on the computer. They're doing it through Zoom. Teachers are on the video live, helping, doing schoolwork through Zoom, which is a great platform. I like it. You know, I talk to a lot of my friends and a lot of my buddies, and it's kind of dope. And but what do you think? What do you think needs to happen? You know, I mean, this is really a pandemic, and this is not just here in the United States. This is global. So this is really tough, man. I mean, you know, you're talking about thousands and millions of kids out of school, you know, and some of them have good homes, some of them don't. So what are the kids doing? Are they out on the streets? And they not even supposed to really be outside on the streets? You know, the kids are not supposed to be out playing in the parks no more. They don't want that. You're supposed to stay 6 feet away from people. You're supposed to have a mask, gloves. You know, you're supposed to constantly wash your hands when you can. Hand sanitizer in your pocket, in your book bag, everywhere you go, you're supposed to at least have all this stuff with you. So it can prevent some of this virus going on. Also, what do you do when you have a bunch of people that's not really respecting the social distance thing? You know, it's so funny. Because I went to City Island yesterday. Me and my wife, we went down to City Island and went down there to just pick up some food and get on out of there. You know, one, two, bang. But guess what? It was, first of all, the lines was crazy. Almost every spot, the lines was crazy. You know, and that's not a good thing, you know, that the lines is going bananas. That's number one. Then number two, you have people getting their food and then standing outside the car. So it's like 4 or 5 of y'all that went down there. So all of y'all piled in one car or y'all just followed each other. But then when y'all get down there, y'all standing right next to each other. Now, the funny thing, the way this virus is working, I'm hearing. You know, I'm not a doctor. I don't practice doctor, you know. But within 6 feet, you can attract the virus. Like, if a person can be carrying the virus and it's not affecting them at all, and you can go on and get it because your immune system or your system is not as strong as others, and you out there chilling and talking and wait, I got to go on to that in a second. But, you know, you got people really, really not practicing social distance. And it's, like, kind of disturbing. Like, I mean, you know, I know people look at it like, yeah, all right, okay. But, you know, but still, it's not right. It's not right. So we have to work on working on the social distance thing because it's very serious. So they down there, they eating their seafood on the car, you know, about four or five of brothers and sisters. They down there eating, enjoying their food, playing the music out the car. Yeah, it was a beautiful day outside. So, yeah, everybody want to be outside. But there's a virus going on outside that you can get sick from and you can die if your immune system is not that strong. So they out there chilling, boom, boom. I look, another group down there. They got liquor bottles on the floor. They sitting down in the chairs like they outside in the park. And it ain't no virus out here. So what do we do? Cuomo is giving out $1,000 fine. You know, $1,000 to a lot of people is not a lot of money. If you feel $1,000 is not a lot of money, you can cash at me at Kubi TV and I'll receive it. You know, just give it to me. That's fine. You don't, you know, it ain't a lot. It ain't nothing to you. Go on, pass it on over to me. I'll take it. I'll do something good with it. It'll be sitting in that bank building up some more. So you go on and send that money over there. So, you know, if you feel that your immune system is strong or is not strong, you can still be a carrier. So, you know, I don't want you next to me like that. You know what I'm saying? My wife get on me all the time. I come out of work. First of all, for 8 full damn hours, I'm wearing a mask and gloves. And I ain't got no damn air to breathe. You know, I got asthma. So, I can't breathe in the mask. So, let alone me wearing the mask outside in the car and driving down the street. I can't do it. I need some air. I need to breathe a little bit. Just, you know, till I get home or get to a place where I got to put it on because I'm going inside of around other people. You know what I'm saying? So that's, you know, that's, if you have any questions and you like to ask any questions or call, you can call in at 914-288-6671. Or you can message me on the Facebook right now, and I can send you a link to the Zoom so we can go live on Zoom and you can ask questions. So you could do either or, you know. I'd rather you basically send me your number so I can send you the link and you can hit me on Zoom. Because as soon as you call me on that 914-288-6671, you're going to interrupt the Facebook Live. But you could listen to me live on the radio out of your house through the system, the surround sound system. You know what I'm saying? You can listen to it at www.rawtruthradio.com and check it out. So, the next topic, or if you have any questions or anything and you want to chime in, you want to say something, or you want to, you know, get it off your chest, say, you know, you want to say something and get it off your chest, hit me up. Hit the link or call in 914-288-6671 and we can make it happen. You know what I'm saying? So, but the next one is sports. NBA. A friend of mine, I was watching his live last night. Well, yesterday during the day. And he had his son in the driveway working out. Very smart. Very good idea. You know, especially if kids want it. And this is what he said. If kids want it, you'll see that the kids want it. Because then they'll be out there working out. You know. And that's what it is. They need to be out there working out. So, he said one day he took his son to the park to work out. Nobody was in the park. So he in there, he working out, working his son out, doing his thing. Next thing you know, one person pop up. Then another person pop up. His own son said, Dad, we got to go. It's time to get out of here. See, that's smart. Smart young man. You know, this is a tough time, you know, because you got to be trapped in the house. And, you know, you necessarily don't really have to be trapped in the house. If you are in an area where or a place where you live and there's not a lot of people around you, like your house is a couple of feet away from each other and stuff like that, you could have your son or your daughter outside in the yard playing around. That's fine, you know. But as far as going to the park and playing next to each other and stuff, you gotta stop that. You can't do that. You know what I'm saying? And it's so funny because a lot of my, you know, a couple of friends of mine passed away. He's like a brother to me, you know. His mom is in the hospital right now. She's doing much better, he said yesterday. A very, very close friend of mine had very small symptoms, and now he's doing much better. So, I mean, I don't want to constantly talk about the negative. You know, I have an aunt, she's doing better, you know. And some of the people are catching it from their jobs, basically, because, you know, frontline workers, you know, firefighters, policemen, garbage men, nurses, doctors. And, you know, it's so sad that because they don't mention one of the top, the elite frontline people, and that's doormen. And porters, because you have a doorman building, you know, we're there to service you in your apartment and in your household because you still need your building clean. We're walking around disinfecting your building for you so you can feel safer to be home. And even if you have to walk out, you are safe walking out because the germs are not being collected around the building. And the news doesn't say it. It's not fair. Because, you know, I'm a doorman and a porter. So it's not fair that you're not shouting me out too in the same, you know, not just because the people in my building are telling me thank you, but I want to hear it on the news too. I want to be walking down the street if I got my doorman outfit on, my doorman suit, I got it on. I want you to clap out your window too. It's only right. It's only right. You know? So, that, you know, that's all I'm saying about that. I mean, you know, keep us on top too with everybody else. You know what I'm saying? So, like I said, if you want to call in, you can call in to 914-288-6671. You know, 914-288-6671. Or send me, or you know what? I might be able to send the link to you so we can connect on Zoom, you know. But yeah, so this is a good thing, you know. A lot of people tuning in, a lot of people listening. Let's get to the sports. What do you think about the sports? What do you think is going to happen with the rest of the season? you know, you talk about basketball, you're talking about hockey. What's going to happen? Are they going to extend it? They already canceled right now, and that's strange because that's during the summer. They already canceled the WNBA. Overseas, basketball is done too. You know, I mean, so what's going to happen? Are they going to extend the season? Or are they just going to end the season with no champion? First time ever. Wow. That would be amazing that there is no NBA champion in 2020. That's crazy. That is crazy. So we got to see what's going to happen with that. Also, upcoming season, NFL. What's going to happen with that? Is it going to be a shorter season this year? Because, you know, you don't know when they're going to be able to go out there and practice. First of all, when they going to even uplift everybody to go back to work? Forget just the sports. Talk about how are you going to get back to work? Talk about the group homes. Let's talk about the group homes. Let's talk about the front line. You see, that's another thing. These are frontline workers too. Group home staff. Clap for them too. Come on. This is crazy. They're frontline workers also taking care of kids that live in the group homes. They're out of school. The only sad thing about some of the kids that are in there is that some of them are smart and they just need a little push on the educational part. So how are they getting their education? How are they going to get their education? What are they doing to get their education? That's what I want to know. You know, how do we go about getting the education to group home kids? Most of them don't want to do work even when the school is up and running. That's number one. So, that's number one. You know, that kids in the schools don't want to, in the group homes don't want to go to class anyway. You know, so explain that. Explain how we're going to help the young ones out there get their education. Also, what are we doing with the kids that are sick? That end up sick. What are we doing with them? And the group homes now. We talk about the group homes. So what I've heard is they're taking kids, putting them in one unit, and trying to quarantine them to a unit. Okay. If they're real sick, then they don't want to get out the bed. But guess what? What about the kid feel that he a little sick, but I'm not sitting in here. I'm not laying in here all day long. I'm not staying in here. Now he wants to get out. What do you do? Do you let him out? Do you restrain him? Do you block the doors? Now, some of the stuff I just mentioned is under the Cornell, because I did, you know, I worked with kids. A lot of people know that I worked with kids for 16 years, you know. Very, very, very good. I enjoyed it. I really did. Towards the last year of my being with, you know, with this certain group home, I couldn't take it no more. But anyway, you're not allowed to block the door by the Cornell model. You're not allowed to block the doors. So, I can't block the doors. This kid is sick. He is real sick. He don't want to sit down. He don't want to lay down. I'm out of here. Now, to me, this is just me now. I don't know. This doesn't go for everybody. But for me, you're putting others in danger. That's the way I feel about it. You're putting others in danger by trying to walk out of here, and you're going to get other people sick, and it's going to spread. Now the whole entire campus is flooded with everybody sick with the corona. You know what I'm saying? And that's not good. So me, I'm looking at my partner. Even though I don't want to touch him because he is sick, I'm going to make sure I got the proper attire on, the proper stuff on. And I'm putting this fool down to the ground. You are not leaving this unit. You are quarantined to this unit. You are not allowed to leave this unit. You're not going out here and getting others sick. What do we do? How do we go about keeping these kids safe in these group homes? And a lot of people know that the kids don't want to be where they are. They don't want to sit there. They don't want to be down and sit. No, I'm not sitting in here. You bugging. I'm out of here. But it's all right because they're going to walk out. That's true. But guess what's going to happen next? Somebody else is going to be sick. The whole entire campus is going to be sick. And who's in trouble now? Because now the head people are going to be like, why did he get out? How did he get out? You know? What did he do to get out? Did he just walk out? Did y'all let him walk out? You know, come on, man. It's a whole bunch of stuff that people that you know and I know that shouldn't go down. But for the most part, that's what happens. So, frontline workers at the group homes, I applaud y'all. Frontline workers at the doorman, porter, and concierge, I applaud y'all. You know, because we out there every day. We all we got. We trying to keep everyone safe and clean and stuff like that. So, you know, I applaud all of you that's really out there working. So, but like I said, the sports is off the market now. Kids might get a fifth year in college. That's on the market now. The Cuomo is giving out $1,000 fine for you not doing the social distances. You know, social distances. You should know about that. $1,000. Like I said, if it's nothing to you, just send me the money and I'll do something for it. I'll do something with it for you. You know, no hesitation. There ain't no problem with that. But yeah, you just do what you got to do right. You know what I'm saying? We're going to go to a little short break, and then I'm going to come back and hit some other topics. That's the truth. Sometimes you just miss somebody. Can't lie, girl, I miss you, shawty. I miss the way you walk, miss the way you talk, miss the way you ride, girl, I miss you. Yeah. Hello, everybody. Welcome back to part two of the Raw Truth Show on Raw Truth Radio. You can listen to it at www.rawtruthradio.com. All my Facebook peoples, I know we logged off, you know, so that's why I wanted everybody to really go to the radio station. And you can also, you know, listen to it. I would love for you guys to listen to it and stuff like that. But yeah, hit me up, because we got some more stuff to talk about. I want to stay a little bit on that topic with the group home. You know, I want to talk about how administrators, what about the administrators? What are they doing? What should they do to help these kids, to help out the staff and stuff like that? I had a couple of people up on to log into Zoom so we can get some, you know, get some feedback from other people. But what should the administrators do for the staff in this situation here that's going on? Okay, first of all, they should be definitely reaching out to every single staff in the units to find out what they need to make a safe environment for all, for the, all the kids, staff, and everyone. You know, so that's what they need to do. Is that's the number one thing they need to do first. Is check and see what the units need. Make sure the food is up to par. You can't really implement like special things to do for the kids in this situation now because of the virus. But you should definitely be able to provide a nurturing environment for the kids because of the crisis that they're going through right now. And the staff, you know, it's a sad thing to say, but, it, you know, it's kind of like the truth. Using food is one of the most soothing things for us humans nowadays. You know what I'm saying? And it's sad to say that food, you know, for some people that might be overweight and some people, you know, that don't eat certain stuff, but it's like kind of nurturing. So why not bake cakes, cupcakes, cookies, things of that nature to soothe the kids, you know, have some tea. They're all talking about how tea is, drinking things hot is helping this with the virus. So why not make special tea for the kids? You understand what I'm saying? Why not provide these things for the kids? Now, what do you do as far as overnight? If you practice during the course of the day from 8 in the morning to 11 p.m. at night, practice things during the course of the day to help these kids and get them semi-tired during the course of the day, you should be fine. You shouldn't have to go through a whole bunch of stuff to basically get them to go to sleep at night. You have them, you know, do some things around the cottage. You know, first of all, you should get some disinfectant spray that is not harmful for the body, meaning that they have all these green this, green that type of disinfectants. They should have that and have the kids sit, first of all, have a team meeting, right? And then have a cottage meeting. What I mean by that is have all the kids sit together and have them and sit there and talk to them and tell them the seriousness about behind what this virus is all about. You know? That's what you need to do. Because once you explain to them about the virus and how it attacks you and what it does to you and stuff like that, then you'll be like, oh man, forget that. I'm not going to be trying to get sick, you know. And are you attacking the virus right away from when you feel something going on? Do you actually feel the tingleness going on? Do you feel the scratchiness going on? Do you feel like things are getting closed up? Once you feel any little bit of any of that stuff, attack it like it's the flu at full blown. Attack it like it's the flu full blown. Because the earlier you catch it, the earlier you can try to stop it. They say hot tea, hot tea, hot, hot, hot. Hot showers. Inhale the steam for 20 minutes. These are things. Once you feel a little scratch on your, I'm talking about a tiny little scratch, attack it like you got the flu full blown. Don't hesitate. Don't hesitate. That's all I got to say. Because if you do it any other way, it's going to get worse. And you don't want that. You understand what I'm saying? So that's what you want to do. So that's what I think we should all, you know, that's what I think you should do, you know. You should really try to attack it in any way, form, fashion that you can to help you out. But we're supposed to have a special guest. Let me see if they're available so I can hit them now and tell them to give us a shout out on Zoom. You know. He was a little nervous coming on, but let's see what happens. Let's see if he's all right now, if he's ready to rock, if he can do it now, you know? Sorry about that, Facebook people, you know? But we back live again. We up and loaded. And waiting to see if... Yeah, I'm waiting to see. If we have someone log in to call in, because they're supposed to go on live and we're supposed to have a conversation about some stuff that's going on in the world today. And also wanted to touch a topic that is very, very serious out here too. But I'm waiting on the person to log in. So, but for the most part, back to the show. This is the Raw Truth Show on Raw Truth Radio on Tuesdays and Wednesdays at 12 p.m. It's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to have some fun. You know, this is the first show back for 2020. It's going pretty good, you know. So, if you have any questions, please hit me up. If you know me direct, you can text me. I'll say it over that, or you can hit me on Facebook. You can also call in at 914-288-6671. And that's it. I mean, you know, let's get busy. You're listening to in the background. This is Corona Mix Volume 1 by Kid Kubi, a.k.a. Chewy, you know. for all my peoples out there. Let's rock and roll. So, the coronavirus. After today, I'm really not going to talk about it a lot no more because, I'm tired of hearing it. I know what we need to do, all of us need to do, and we continue to keep doing it, and that's fine, that ain't no problem. But it just feels like it's, like, sad all the time. Like, that's all you listen to is Corona, Corona this, Corona that. Like, it's something sad all day long. And, Hello, caller. You are calling the Raw Truth Show. How can I help you? I'm sorry, say it again. Who's calling?
I said hello, how are you?
All right, how are you?
I'm okay, I'm good. My name is Brownsy.
Uh-huh.
I just had a few questions to ask.
Okay, sure, go ahead.
I think that your radio show was really cool. It's my first time really tuning in to what you got going on. But I wanted to ask you something because you were talking about the corona, the COVID-19 virus, COVID-19, they call it. We were talking about the virus and stuff and about how we need to protect ourselves and whatnot, and I definitely agree with you. My question to you is, do you believe that this is a government situation? Because it strikes me mighty odd how situations have begun to progress as far as, it rapidly getting sick. Like from the country, having very ill ways of food, from the wet markets or whatever. And then it comes people in America and all over. It's a pandemic because but it comes over to our country and then we get all messed up behind it. And now we have to depend on the very same people that have spread this disease. We have to depend on them for their supply. How do you feel about, how do you think that should be addressed, or how do you feel about the situation?
Okay, caller, thank you for calling, and I'm going to answer the questions right now. First of all, it came from, like you said, another country, yes, from the wet market and the foods and stuff like that. I don't think it was planned to happen. I'm not too sure about that because, I'm not in that field or anything. But I believe that once we heard about it as a government, as the United States, once we heard about it, we should have took actions ASAP for people that was abroad, that was traveling from there and other countries back to the United States. I think we should have took full-blown action. I think we should have...
Okay, so would you agree that we dropped... I'm sorry,
go ahead.
So would you agree that we dropped the ball?
I believe that. I really do believe that we dropped the ball on that. And I think the way this, there's a couple of ships that's out in the waters near Florida that are not allowed to dock. That are not allowed to dock at Florida. Okay? So, thank you for calling, caller. I'm going to answer your question, though. So, I think we dropped the ball big time. I think, like I said, there's a ship out in the middle of There's a ship out in the middle of the ocean near Florida that they are not letting dock at Florida. So they're doing the quarantine there on the ship. They're testing on the ship. People are passing away on the ship, you know. But there are people that's being released that don't have it and not carriers. So I think, personally, I think we should have did something like that from the beginning when it came down to this whole situation of this corona thing, you know. But I don't, you know, I'm not into government. I'm not, you know, I'm not part of that. I can't make a call and say, yo, don't let that plane land here. Don't let it land, fly it around until, that's right, I can't do that, you know. I wish I had the power to do it, but I don't. But thanks for calling, caller. Brownsy was her name. Thank you for calling, Brownsy. And tune into the show tomorrow, too, because we're going to have some good topics and good stuff to talk about. I'm going to work out a different way of having callers and going live and stuff like that. I'll figure it all out today for, you know, for the show tomorrow. But for the most part, we here, man. Sports. Oh, about one thing about sports too. Let me just hit this. ESPN is trying to provide you with sports. They're trying to find out ways of keeping you engaged on ESPN. One of the ways that I notice and I kind of like to that they're engaging us with the sports are they playing some of the old school games, like, you know, Michael Jordan against the Knicks, Indiana against the Knicks, stuff like that. That was very, you know, high tense games and stuff. And one thing that I noticed that they're doing now too is they're playing the NBA 2K basketball live on ESPN. They got the players playing, and KD got bumped the first round, and he was salty. What's his name? I forget his name. The big fella that got hurt, that played for Sacramento, went to Golden State, and got hurt at Golden State. Now they traded him again to, I forget. But he was playing against Drummond's, and Drummond's beat him by like 20 or something like that. So, but I mean, it's kind of cool because, you know, I like watching, you know, I like PlayStation. You know, some people ain't into it. I'm a PlayStation head. Born and raised on PlayStation. So, but ESPN is trying to keep everybody engaged, trying to keep people down with the sports, you know, and that's cool. I agree with it. You know what I mean? But we'll see what happens, you know, because we don't have a season coming. There is no more season. What's going to happen next? Who's going to be on? So, but you can tune in next week. Not next week, tomorrow. Tomorrow at 12 o'clock. Tune in to the Raw Truth Show on www.rawtruthradio.com. This is the first show back for 2020. And we're going to have special guests, special topics, and also we got the Corona Mix Volume 1 that Facebook won't allow let play, but Raw Truth Radio is where it's at. So if you want to listen to it, you can listen to it at rawtruthradio.com. It's also on my YouTube channel, Kubi TV. Check it out. Kubi TV YouTube channel. That's where you can check out the Corona Mix and also all the other shows. So, you know, I want to thank everybody for tuning into the show. I want to thank the caller that called in. I want to thank the frontline people that's coming to work, going to work, trying, you know, keeping people safe. Make sure you wash your hands, wash your face, wear the gloves, face mask, all that stuff. If you don't have the mask, it's okay, they said, to wear scarves, things, just something to cover is fine for right now. Cover, cover, cover. My wife tells me this every day, you know, but sometimes I'm a hard-headed little fella, you know, and that's what it is. But like I said, I want to thank everybody for tuning into the show. And check it out tomorrow at 12 o'clock. And we'll be up and running. Thanks for tuning in. So he knows he can't keep up. Oh no. What we do, promise I'm not giving up on you. Cause he gave up. He's a zero. Your ex man, he's a zero.